We're gonna take a look at what linked lists are in this video, and we're gonna do that with the Go programming language. And I'm gonna preview that code for you here in a second, and then I'll teach you what linked lists are, and then you'll see me recode this code that I'm gonna show you. So here's the code for linked lists. You could see it on the screen right there, and you could also see it, the end of it right here, so you could pause the video and take a look at it. We're gonna code that up in a second. And if you wanna see this code, you could come into GitHub. So my GitHub user account is goes to 11, and come into the Learn to Code Go version 3 repo right there. And this is the repo for this course here. So if you wanna learn more about the Go programming language, you could Google Udemy Todd McLeod and come down here to this Learn How to Code Google's Go Golang programming language course. But this is the code base for all of that. And we are working in a BK linked list 05. So I practiced it here a couple of times just so I could say it all smoothly. And that's where I did those practices. All right, so what is a linked list? A linked list is where you have a data structure that stores some data, and part of the data that it stores is like a pointer to where the next data structure is. And these individual data structures, you can see them here on the screen, they're called nodes, right? And then the data that's stored, they'll store some data like this is storing 12, this is storing 99, this is storing 37, but it's also storing a pointer to the next node. And so you could see, okay, where's the next node exist? It tells you the memory address, the address in memory where that next node exists. And then you could get there by going to that memory location, find the next node, find the data, including the pointer to the next node, and then find the data, including the pointer to the next node. And you could do that all the way through the list, thus its name, linked list. And you might ask yourself, hey, why do a linked list as opposed to doing a slice or an array? I asked that same question of ChatGPT, and here's the answer. So I'll copy and paste this description right here from ChatGPT down into the description of the video so you could read through that thinking. And I thought the answer was really great. Actually, I'm loving ChatGPT for finding answers in that way and quickly sharing information with people. Just, you gotta check it for accuracy, make sure it's right, but it's a totally handy dandy deal. All right, so let's see how to code up a linked list. I'm gonna copy, get rid of all that. I'm gonna start out with package main, and then func main, and then I'm going to have a data structure, which is going to be my node. And that node is going to store some data, and it'll be an int, and it's also going to store the pointer to the next node, right? So here is my data, and then we have the pointer to the next node right there. And then for every linked list, right, every linked list will start out at some node, and that node is referred to as the head. Right, and so we'll have a memory address where our linked list starts, and that's the head of the linked list. So that's how that works right there. And then we're gonna create some list, and so this will just be my list, and my list will be a linked list, like that. And we'll have some functions here, and so the first function will be to add a node to our linked list. And so I'm gonna create a receiver here to make this function a method, and this receiver will be like that. And we'll call this add node to end. And it'll take in some data, right? Because we want to add some data to the end. So we'll have that function. And then we'll use that function here. We'll add nodes to the end like that. And we'll just add a couple of different nodes with different pieces of data so we could see those. And then we'll create one more function. And this function here will be to print our list. And it won't have any parameters, so we'll take no arguments, and we'll print our list right there. So when we're all done, we could print that list out, and that's what that is going to look like. So that's what we're gonna create. So now all we have to do is create it, and that means we have to write these functions. And so for this first function here, I wanna add a node to the list, so I'm gonna create a new node. And I'm working with pointer semantics here. And so it's going to be a pointer to where this node is. And the node is going to have some data, and that's the data I passed in. And I don't know the pointer to the node after this yet. So that pointer, it's going to be nil until I know what that pointer is. And then the next thing I need to do is I need to figure out if I already have a list or not. And so I'm going to do an if statement here. And so if my list head is equal to nil, I don't have a list yet, right? Otherwise, I have a list, and I'm gonna do something else. And so if I don't have a list yet, my list needs to start somewhere, so my list head will be equal to my new node. And if I already have a list, I wanna loop through this list, and I wanna loop through it and find the last, right, the last node in the list, and then I want to add my new node right, as the last node in the list. And so to loop through that, I'm going to use a for statement. And what I'm going to look for, but first I got to have a current node, right? So cn here is going to be is current node. Okay, so I got to find, I need to find the end of the list, start at the beginning, then loop through the list, right? And so I'm going to have my cn, and cn is going to be my current node. And my current node is going to start out at my list head because I'm going to start at the beginning. So current node is current node. And I'll just put this here, start at the beginning. That's where that comment makes sense to me, right? The beginning is list head, and that's my current node. And I'm going to loop through the list, right, to find the end of the list. So I'll make this comment here, loop through the list to find the end of the list. And we'll get rid of that comment right there. And so to loop through this list, I'm going to be at my current node, and I want to, you know, see what's the next node. And so that's going to be, you know, as long as like my cn next is not nil, I'm not yet at the end of the list. Does that make sense? Right? Because when my node no longer has something to point towards, so the node that I'm on, it says, wait, this is nil. So it's no longer going to loop, and I know I will be at the end of the list when it's no longer looping. Does that make sense? Right? So my current node, when next is nil, it's not pointing to anything because I'm at the end of the list, so it can't point to anything. And so to get this loop to work and just to keep going through it, I need to go from my current node, right? The next current node that I need to go to is going to be the one that it's pointing towards. So when I'm at this current node here and it's not nil, right? That's not nil, so this is now the current node I want to go to. And then I'm at this next current node, right? And it's pointing to the node after that. And if it's not nil, I'm going to take that address and have that be the next address that I go to. And so it just kind of loops through this until it gets to the case where it is nil, at which point it leaves the loop. And at that point, I could say that my current node dot next, right, which is that one that used to be the end of the list, I'm going to now have that point towards, right, the new node. Right? So I'm saying, hey, this pointer here, the memory address, is going to be the memory address of this new node I just created. And so now I've added an item to the end of my list. Takes a little bit of time. I coded this up a couple of times just so I could say all that well and clearly. So just practice coding that a couple of times. Look at it, code it, put it away, try to code it from memory, thinking it through and do that, and after a while it makes sense. So next thing I need to do is just loop through my list and print it. And so again, we're going to do something similar here, and I need to start at the beginning of the list. And so I'm just going to do start at the beginning. And to start at the beginning, I need some current node if I'm going to be looping through it, and that current node is going to start out at the beginning, which is going to be right there. And now loop through the list. And so we're going to do another for statement here. And so in here, we're going to say for cn is not equal to nil. And so while, you know, the node that we're at, right, while there's a node, you know, it's not equal to nil, we're going to do our loop. And then we're going to do a print here. We're going to print out some information. And so we'll get that filled in a second. But let's finish thinking through our loop here. And so for this current node not equal to nil, how do we go to the next node? Well, we've got this cn next, right, which is our next node, and we need that to become our new cn. And so that's how we go to the next one. And when we finally get to the last node on the list, right, the cn next won't be pointing towards anything. It'll be nil, so this will now become nil. That will become nil. And so this will no longer evaluate as true, right? Noise, kids. And so we'll exit the list. And so that will be the end of it right there. So what do we want to print? We want to print here the first we want to say current node address, and that will be percent %P, and that will be our current node. And then we're also going to print node data, and that will be percent %D because it's decimal, and so that will be CN data. And then we're also going to print our CN, what's the address of the next node. And so we'll do another tab here, and we'll say next node is at CNX, which will be, again, another pointer. And so that's what we want to print out. So that's coding it up. Let's take, oh, and then very importantly, so we get our data readable, a new line after all of that. So now let's take a look at this running. And so I'm gonna go run main.go and do it out. And you can see here that our current node is at this address, the data is 1, and the next node is 8250. Well, here's that next node. It's pointing to, right? It's pointing to this next memory address, 8250, where the data is 2. And then this points to the next memory address, 260, where the data is 3. And then that points to the next memory address, 270, where the data is 4, and the next node is nothing, right? So that's how a linked list works. If you have a different solution, code up your different solution, control A, control C, copy it, and then go to the Go Playground. And in the Go Playground, drop in your new solution like that, paste it in, and share it, and then copy that code and put it down in the description of this video so we could see just novel ways. Doesn't have to be a better way, but just novel ways that you could also create a linked list. All right, I hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, subscribe, like, comment, follow, tell me you enjoyed it. I like hearing about that. And also, if you want to learn more about Go, go check out my course, Udemy, Todd McLeod. See you next time.